I want to take just a moment and give you an overview of particle LODs, or levels of detail. They are a way that you can take a particle system and make it simpler as you move away from it. That is their default behavior anyway. They can also be accessed directly through code. And just as a quick aside, not something we're going to explore here, this was used in the Infinity Blade games, which given was Unreal Engine 3, but the technique would work in 4. You can use particle LODs directly in code to change the level of detail of a particle system based on the hardware you were running. So if you were running Infinity Blade on a lower-end iPhone, you would get a simpler version of the particle system because they were driving LODs based on your hardware spec. So there's a lot of ways they could be applied, not all of which we're going to explore here. We're just going to focus on how they're controlled by way of distance. Now, to, I guess, get the theory across early on, let's consider a particle system that looked like smoke, right? So I'll just sketch out the most amazing smoke you've ever seen, like so. And let's say your camera is going to get closer and farther away from it during the game. Now, it kind of goes without saying, but you gotta stop and think about it. As you move away from an object in a game, that object gets smaller. As it gets smaller, it uses less screen space. And as it uses less screen space, it requires fewer pixels of your monitor. And as it does that, it requires less detail to render properly, which is the whole idea behind LODs. But here's how you're gonna set them up. You're going to establish a distance, and this distance can be anything you want, but we're going to set it to about 1,000, at least for this hand-drawn example. I'll set it to something much lower to make it a lot more visible when we do it in Unreal. So you'd say for the first 1,000 centimeters, or 1,000 Unreal units, you would be looking at LOD 0. This is going to be your highest level of detail. This is where the particle effect is going to look the prettiest. Now, as you move farther away, let's say to 2,000, you might step to LOD 1, and this could be something like medium detail. And then once you made it to 3,000 and beyond, so you would be at LOD 2, which would be your lowest level of detail. Now, the thing here is you can have as many LODs as you want. You're not limited to just 3. You could have 100 if it made you feel better, but you should be able to manage them, and you probably won't need more than a few. It really depends on how much explicit control you want over the particle system as you get closer and farther away from it. Now, to illustrate how to set these up, let's jump back into Unreal. I'm going to bring in the P smoke particle system, which is included with the starter content. And I have already taken the liberty of jumping into the spawn module inside of this and setting its spawn rate to something really high, like 50 in this case. I thought it was 500, but there's a decimal point in there. So 50 means we're gonna get a whole lot of smoke, as you can see. Now, to set up LODs, we have a few things to do. First off, I'm gonna check and see if there are any LODs here using my LOD controls at the top. If I set this to 1, you'll notice it won't let me. So currently I have no LODs. There's also another way to check. If I click on a blank spot here in the emitter list, we can take a look at the particle system's properties, and under LOD distances, I only have an entry for 0, which means I only have one LOD. Now, I have LOD buttons at the top. These allow me to create new LODs and to step between them however I'd like. What I'm going to do is add another LOD. So we'll add a lower LOD, or before the current one. Really, at this point, it doesn't matter because I only have one. I can add one after or one before. Now, you'll notice over here in my details panel, I have two LOD distances available, and I can take my LOD and now set it to 1. I have two different settings. Now, I want to mention the LOD method here. This is set to automatic. As an artist, you're probably going to leave it at automatic forever. But if you grab this, you'll notice there's some other settings. You have direct set, which means you could talk to this directly through code. You also have activate automatic. And the differences between those are actually spelled out pretty well in the tooltip. But if you're not actually handling this by way of code or doing anything special or fancy with it, automatic is going to be your go-to. You can also grab the LOD distance check time. This is how often the system is going to check and make sure that you are set to the proper LOD. You don't want it to do this all the time. Right now it's doing it, 4 times a second, which should be more than enough. You shouldn't even really be able to feel the transition at that point. You could probably set it much lower if you wanted to. Now, we're going to take LOD1, and all we're doing here is changing the distance that this is going to work. Now, 1,000 is great, but to really drive this home and make it clear what we're showing off, I'm going to leave this really low, so like only 300 units away. Now notice something, when we change our LOD, so here's 0, this is our highest level of detail. When we switch over to 1, notice that all of my modules get grayed out. That's because they've automatically been downscaled by Cascade. If I want to change them or make any edits to them, I need to right click and duplicate from a higher one, or I could share from a higher if I wanted to, but I'm going to duplicate, and now that clears this up and it's set to its original value, which is 50. I'm going to pull that down really low to, say, 0.5. That means I'm only going to get one every other second, just one little puff. Then let's take lifetime, and I'll duplicate that from higher as well. And currently, my lifetime was set to 5 to 6 seconds. Let's set this to 2 to 3 seconds. So a lot fewer particles, and they don't live for as long. And that's a pretty obvious change between that and my highest level of detail. So now with just that done, let's go ahead and take a look in the view. We can go ahead and hit play. And if we're really close, you see we've got a lot of smoke. As soon as we get farther than, in this case, 300 units away, notice what happens. It stops spawning, and now we're only getting one every couple of seconds with a really short lifespan. Now that is an extreme example, right? Normally you wouldn't want to do this to your LODs, but my goal here is just to get the point across so that you can understand how these LODs work and how you can go about setting them up. Generally what you'd want to do is say over the first 1,000 units you do nothing. Maybe beyond that you can take an entire emitter and you could turn it off. For example, if I come over here to LOD1, and let's say I have two different emitters. Let's just take this emitter and I'll duplicate it. And on this one, let's come back over to LOD0. So on my second smoke emitter, just to differentiate it, let's move it off to the side. So I should probably add something like an initial location. I'll right click, go to location. We'll set an initial location. And I'll move that up just again. Actually, I'm sorry, I've got an initial location in here, but it's a sphere and it's got a start load, so that's fine. We can delete that out. We can just use the sphere. And we're gonna take X and offset it by about 100. So now I've got two separate plumes of smoke. And if I take the background color and kick that up, it'll be a little easier to see those. Let's take the color over life for the second one, and it's set to a constant curve. That's all well and good. Let's change it from this sort of dirty brownish color. Let's just kick it up so it'll be like the other one is like a really intense red smoke. That's really just so that we can see the difference between the two for no other reason than that. And I'll kick it up even further. Now the reason I'm doing this is to prove a point, really. So let me take my second LOD distance. We had it at 300 a little while ago. Let's set that up to about 1,000. And now at LOD1, what I'm gonna do is turn off the red smoke. And notice what happens here. Let's take our spawn rate. Let's put that back up to something a little more reasonable, say 2. And we'll take our lifetime, and that can be between 4 and 5. So it is different, but it's not super different than it was. But notice, if I switch back down to LOD0, suddenly my red smoke is active again. Even your activation settings on your emitters is going to be respected within each LOD. So now, if we take a look here in the view, and we hit play. So I've got two plumes of smoke. And if I get further than 1,000 units away, we lose the red smoke. Again, it's an extreme example, but it shows you that your LODs can do a lot of different things. So for example, if you had a really complicated fire effect that had sparks and it had all kinds of other stuff, like all sorts of bits and pieces, you could have those steadily start to disappear the farther away you get from your particle system. That is just a quick overview of LODs. That wraps things up for this video. Thanks for watching.